Shakespeare, Lincoln, Einstein, staples of the syllabus, but a class on Fonzie?
Because I'm the Fonz, huh? Hey.
Happy Days was appointment viewing in 1975 on Tuesday nights for millions of American families, like the Tenutos of Chicago. For John Tenuto, it's more than nostalgia, it's sociology.
If you put a fad on a television show today...
That's what he teaches at the College of Lake County. His new class is about TV and film from the 70s.
If you put fun into learning, it's just a completely different experience. It's for the teacher, for the students, and I think that's really the main motivation for these kinds of classes.
In the 80s, cable gave me my MTV. Now technology gives me my playlist. But in the 1970s, society shared stories on TV.
I mean, there was nothing. I mean, absolutely nothing. Not till the wedding night.
Yeah, and even then.
So it was like All in the Family. They, you know, they really sort of held up a mirror to what America was. And it's, you know, it's... reflecting actually what happened in the 60s, happened on TV in the 70s. Women's rights, civil rights.
Now I suppose you're going to tell me that the black man has had the same opportunity in this country as you?
More. He's had more. I didn't have no million people out there marching and protesting to get me my job.
No, his uncle got it for him.
If you watch a show like All in the Family, although they used real language and tried to be realistic, it was obviously a set. You could tell it was a television show. Today's shows look very much like reality. And sometimes it's harder to talk about social issues, controversial social issues, if you're too real.
The lessons were cushioned a bit by simple stages, laugh tracks, and the infamous 70s catchphrase.
Sit on it, Richie.
Then the next day, we're all doing it. We're all imitating Fonzie or Barbarino or whatever.
Up your nose with rubber hose.
And now there isn't that anymore because 30 people in the class could have been watching 30 different shows.
And Tenuto says that makes the 70s the last great decade for pop culture.
And how that, I think the main thing is how that built community. If they can get an idea of how common experiences like that help to bond people together. So you and I have never met who are nearly the same age. We can sit down and talk about these common childhood experiences.
That experience may be coming to an end, but Tenuto says that because nostalgia runs in 20-year cycles, it can bring different generations together. Today you see a resurgence of all things 80s, like Transformers. The 70s were about the 50s, Happy Days, and Grease. We can share these experiences with our children. The Brady Bunch is still in reruns. Tenuto says his class will give students the tools to study the trends through these nostalgic shows to see how pop culture transforms history. It's a fun lesson that would make Mr. Kotter proud. Larry Potash, WGN News.